Meet Jerry. After out and about one day, he ate a muffin. One simple muffin. The next day, he started having abdominal pains and diarrhea. So he saw a doctor. The doctor told him that he had gluten intolerance, but what exactly does that mean? Today I'm going to be talking about HLA, or human leukocytic antigens. The specific HLA I'll be talking about is DQ2, in which causes celiac disease, or gluten intolerance. But to first understand this, one must understand what a human leukocytic antigen really is. HLA are complexes that help the immune system by distinguishing proteins made by the body in foreign invaders, like viruses and bacteria. Some HLA genes have hundreds of identified versions. These are called alleles, each with a given number. Each immune system is different. Therefore, they have a wide range of HLA that can be found in the body. Diseases are also common amongst some HLA, as more than 100 diseases have been associated with different alleles of HLA genes. That's where the HLA DQ2 molecule comes into play, as it correlates with celiac disease. In fact, HLA DQ2 heterodimer is prevalent and present in 90% of patients with CD, or celiac disease. This molecule can either be cis or trans, and is produced by proteins from HLA DQA1 and HLA DQB1, which bind to one another and become an antigen-binding DQAB heterodimer, HLA DQ2. These attach to the gluten peptides outside the cell and cause an immune response responding to a segment of protein called gliadin. The celiac disease is a result from this response, as the response causes damage and inflammation to the body's organs and tissues, also leads to other symptoms of CD. CD is where the immune system is abnormally sensitive to gluten, which is found in wheat, rye, and barley, and can develop at any age. In many cases, one might not even know that they have the disease. So here's a few symptoms that Jerry might have in the future once he decides to eat another muffin. One of the main symptoms is inflammation. This affects the villi, which are small projections that line the intestines and help absorb nutrients. CD makes the villi shorten until flattened out, so they no longer can absorb these nutrients. Other symptoms include diarrhea, abdominal pain, swelling, weight loss, etc. And in the worst case, CD may increase the chances of getting gastrointestinal cancer, cancers like small intestine cancer, or esophagus cancer. In the grand scheme of things, celiac disease is very common, as about 100 people have the disease. But there are ways to remedy this disease. The main way being to stop eating gluten, which I know is very hard, especially for Jerry and his love for muffins, but it's definitely one way to do things. This can be obtained by a gluten-free diet, which is becoming more and more available by more and more gluten-free options and food products. And maybe Jerry can just find that gluten-free muffin alternative. Or maybe he just stops eating muffins. The hardships of celiac disease.